That was a Bollywood song called Mustakalandar, which I think many of you know.
Yeah.
We're going to play a Qawwali song called Akya Udiktiyam.
Thank you.
to Sunny Singh on trumpet. Sunny Singh. Jonathan Hafner on soprano saxophone. So we're going to play an original song for you now. This is called Sialkot. It's a city in Pakistan in western Punjab where my parents are from. I wrote this for them several years ago. And it has that Punjabi flavor in it, so I hope you enjoy it.
Yeah.
This is Jonathan Goldberger on guitar, everyone. Okay, we're gonna play another song that you might know. It's a Sufi song. It's called Damad Mustakalender.
Thank you. check. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm back again. I know you guys don't want to see my face, you want to see them perform, but we will have a short 5-minute break for prayers. But Ashwin has a surprise for all of you.
But I know any Indian who listens to this kind of songs cannot sit in their seats. So after the prayer break, you're going to calm down, you're going to go crazy with them, they're going to play amazing songs. So stay in your seats, don't leave, come back after your prayer breaks, we're going to go crazy.
The floor is open for questions and any sort of interaction that you would like to do with the Red Baraat. So feel free, just raise your hands up and I'll be there. And these guys are open, these guys are free.
Yes, please ask any questions. This is our first time in the UAE, and as you know, we were brought here by the U.S. Consulate General of Dubai, and also the U.S. Embassy in Abu Dhabi, and we're just so pleased to be here with you and to play for you and to have your wonderful smiles and interaction with us. So let's take this time to have any questions, anything you have to ask us. We'd love to have a dialogue. Anyone?
All right, 10 minutes. So please introduce yourself, Nadia. But yeah, you can just introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Nadia. I wanted to ask, where did you come up with your name, Red Baraat?
Well, as most of you may know, a Baraat is a procession that happens during the wedding time from a groom's side to a bride's side. It involves dhol drumming, brass band playing, singing and dancing. It's a big joyous occasion. So the Baraat stemmed from, I was born and raised in New York, but my parents come from Punjab, so I'd spend many of my summers back in India. And the first time I remember a brass band, I was 5 years old. My mamaji, my uncle, was getting married. And I remember kind of waking up in the beginning of the Baraat on my cousin's side of the house and came outside and just heard this cacophonous brass band and dhol playing. And it stuck with me ever since, and I would see, as many of you know, there's so many bands per city in India and in Delhi and in Rajasthan and all places that you go, there's all these brass bands working and going from wedding to wedding, so it's always just stuck with me. But the idea of Baraat is there. The idea of red is for the idea of excitement, of love, of energy. As you know, it's the typical color worn at weddings, but it's also just my favorite color. Sounds better than blue Baraat. And the sound that you're hearing, though, really kind of stems from this idea of American music and cultural influences from all spectrums coming in. Growing up in America, and as a lot of these guys can also say, or also growing up in Canada, Rohan's from Canada, we're exposed to so many different types of music, and most of us here are jazz musicians, so we study and listen to all types of music. So this music, the foundation is Indian brass band Baraat music, but you hear jazz, you hear funk, you hear go-go, you hear a bunch of different influences coming in because of everyone's contribution to the band. What other questions are there?
All right, there's someone with a question. All right, this little girl named Fizza, she wants to talk to you guys and say hello to you people.
Yeah.
And she's been enjoying it, dancing all around.
Oh, yes.
As we're watching. So, Fizza, say hello to them.
Hi.
Hello.
My name's actually
Sharjah, and my question for you is, do you see your band as something, like there are a lot of performers coming up right now that are fusing their South Asian heritage with their upbringing, whether it's in the UK or the US, like Raja Kumari or the Sweatshop Boys. Do you see yourself as like part of that sort of movement that's like, I know you have a very diverse group of people in the band, but I just wonder if you sort of see yourself like that, like you're trying to blend the South Asian background with the surroundings that you grew up in.
Yeah, I think it's not something that's contrived or put a lot of effort into. You know, it's really just a natural expression of growing up in the States as first generation, and the only family I had there were my immediate parents and my siblings. All the rest of my family lives back in India or in London. And so for me, composing was a way of reconciling these Eastern tradition I grew up with the Western tradition. You know, a very strong Jain religion background, strong Indian background, strong Punjabi background. But then growing up in the West, where maybe it wasn't so familiar in the city that I grew up in. So music for me was very much that way of bridging this stuff. And, you know, whether it's a movement or not, I mean, I think you can definitely say there's a lot of people doing that nowadays. And you can definitely see in the UK, there's different movements that happen with the Asian underground in UK in the mid-90s with Talvin Singh and Nitin Sawhney and Tiger Style, like all types of folks were doing it. And you're having now another bridge happening in America with, as you said, the Sweatshop Boys, and there's a whole crew of people in the jazz world, there's Vijay Iyer. But what's interesting about it in America is it's so diverse and eclectic in their expression of what their heritage is. You know, there's a great Sri Lankan singer, songwriter living out in San Francisco named B. Beeman. There's DJ Reka, of course, whose original roots are UK, but really has spent most of her life in New York. Vijay, again, is South Indian. And Rudresh Mahantapa, South Indian, Himanshu Suri from Sweatshop Boys, or Das Racist, Punjabi. So there's an Aruj Aftab, there's Pakistanis as well. So everyone's having their very interesting, eclectic, diverse expression, which is beautiful, you know. And I think it's all something very natural for all the artists doing it.
One more question from up here.
Hi, my name is Hanima. I was wondering, like, how did you guys form this band? How did you guys all
meet?
How do we all meet? In New York City. That's how we found each other. This band was formed 8 years ago. And just playing in so many different circles, we all come from a wide variety of backgrounds, of musical backgrounds. And we were all in New York at the same time, and the band was formed 8 years ago. Maybe each of you can kind of dive in and just talk about what you were doing in New York musically at the time that we met.
Yeah, totally. So I've known Sunny for probably like 13 years. And you know, I used to play in a rock band. I also used to play in a lot of ska and reggae bands, so really different scenes, bringing in a little bit of the South Asian influence, but less so. And I met Sunny through a Hindustani classical vocalist, and that was really my foray into digging back into sort of my Punjabi and South Asian roots in music, because I was doing really different stuff. And so when he decided to put together, really it began as a Baraat band, right? We actually began as an actual Baraat band, marching and playing it at Baraats at weddings. He called me up and I was like, yes, I'm so into that. And then a few years later, you know, we find ourselves on stages around the world. It's been a pretty amazing journey.
Woo!
Yeah.
John has an interesting background also.
Yeah, for sure. I started out as a classical tuba player, studying orchestral repertoire, composing for orchestra and chamber ensembles, conducting contemporary music. And I kind of came to the sousaphone, which is like the tuba but somewhat different, and I came to these styles and kind of wanted to learn just enough but still inform it with my own studies. And I think the clash of that somewhat spawned some of the beauty we have, for sure. And just met me, Sunny Jain, in New York City. And you know, we all, he's like the degree of separation for all of us. You know, we all knew, him, so.
New York, you know, if you go to New York, there's people there from all the country, all the world, you know, playing music with people from different backgrounds and different age groups. And so I did some gigs with some of these other guys in other bands. I lived in New Jersey with Sunny for a little while, maybe like 20 years ago. We started doing jazz gigs around New York City. Did some gigs in the streets. And so yeah, I'm just saying, I guess it's just like maybe like the city. You live in that city, there's people from all over the place, you know, playing different kinds of music, and then next thing you know, you're playing here, you know. Yeah, speaking of New York City, I remember Jonathan Goldberg, our guitarist, was just mentioning, what, like 3 weeks ago, he had the opportunity to play with traditional Korean musicians, right? It was just 3 weeks ago. They were in town with some other friends of his, a drummer and piano player, and they happened to get together and jam. That's just the kind of environment we're very fortunate to live in terms of the musicians and artists that are there to create and really experience that symbiotic relationship with anyone and everything, whether it's different mediums, sculpting or painting and music, or it's different cultures and different types of music vocabulary. We all thrive on that dialogue, that back and forth. And that was really the basis for this band coming together.
Ladies and gentlemen, I know what you've all been waiting for. So he's going to go and jam, so feel free to come down and go crazy. Doesn't matter how old you are, kids, students, professors, whoever want to dance, go ahead. Let's go crazy. Just enjoy it. Well, we have 15 minutes, just enjoy your time.
Okay, you guys ready?
Yep.
I know I'm ready. This one's a Bollywood song called Mindi Lagake Rapna. This song is called Horizon Line. Horizon Line. Thank you. We're gonna play one more song. Do we have time for one more? Yeah. We have time for two more. How much time do we have? We're gonna play another song by Gurdas Khan. It's called Together We Sound. We'll do Dela Mendy later. Do we have time for two or three more songs? Anyone know? Okay, well, here's this song. So, button. Here we go. The on-off button. The old on-off button. We're gonna play a song for a festival called Holi. And we're gonna play a popular song from the movie. Oh boy, I'm blanking. Sholay, right? Sholay. This one's called Holi Kitin. Darius Chris Edderton on drum set. John Altieri on sousaphone. Darius Christian on trombone. Roland Kalani on percussion. Jonathan Hatton on soprano. Jonathan Goldberger on guitar. Sunny Singh on trumpet. My name is Sunny Jain on the dhol.
I'm not taking pictures. This takes video, by the way.